Hey there, welcome back. We're still in Module 2, which is getting started, and we're all the way down to Section 2, Part 2, where we're talking about creating your company file. We had actually started going through the EasyStep interview, and we had to stop due to the time constraints on the video, but let's go ahead and finish that up now so you can go ahead and get your company file set up. This question asks, do you have employees? Now, I find this question very misleading because you'll notice it's asking if you have W-2 employees and also 1099 contractors. Something to keep in mind, 1099 contractors have absolutely nothing to do with your payroll. The way they're treated in QuickBooks is they're entered as a vendor. And you'll see when I show you how to set up vendors that there's going to be a checkbox where you tell it that they will get a 1099. So don't confuse the two. By saying yes here, you're basically just turning the icons on your home screen. So if you wanted to sign up for the payroll service later, you could do that. I'm going to go ahead and click next. And now it's asking us about using accounts in QuickBooks. So we're going to click next one more time so we can answer some of these questions. Here it says, select a date to start tracking your finances. You can start with the beginning of the year, or you can use today's date. Now, if you came to me right now and said, I'm ready to purchase QuickBooks, what date should I start with? It's almost the end of the year, so you may want to consider starting with today or the current month, maybe the beginning of the month. I'd make that date correspond with your last bank statement. So if the statement cut off on the 1st, make this correspond with that. Now if you wanted to go back and start at the beginning of the year, you could. Just remember you have a lot of data to enter. Reports are only as accurate as the data you have in here. So this will be up to you, whichever date you'd like to start with. I'll just go ahead and say the beginning of the fiscal year and click next. Here is the generic chart of accounts that it created for us based on how we answered all of the questions. If I look at this list and I say, you know, I happen to use a lot of subcontracted services, I can check that off here if I'd like. But what I want to do now is leave the list the way it is because we are going to go ahead and click next. See how it says go to setup? We're going to click on that. Now we're not completely finished setting up our file. We've still got a few more things to do here. So what we're going to do is we're going to be looking at a couple of different things as far as the company overview, which is the next section. And then we'll also talk about some of the components of the QuickBooks environment so we can actually turn some options on or off and that sort of thing. So let's go ahead and wrap up this particular section and let's go to section 3 and talk about the My Company overview.
Hi, I'm Molly. Thanks for watching. If you need additional QuickBooks Pro training to help you effectively manage your small business, check out our complete training courses for QuickBooks Pro. Click the Learn More button on the left, and I'll see you next week with additional videos.